Morning, guys. Just it's 11:40. I did get up really late. I've only been awake 40 minutes, but I did wake up about 6:30. I then couldn't fall back to sleep for bloody ages, so. And then when I did fall back to sleep, I slept for quite a long time. And yet another, I've just been having crappy night's sleep lately. And anyway, parcel did arrive. The Canon camera has charged. Got hair. I am dressed, I just haven't put a shirt on yet. Canon camera has charged. There's a little red light. I can unplug that now, can't I? There we go. I need to sort these shelves out. I've been through all the memory cards I've got. The SD memory cards. I've got a gigabyte one missing. I don't know where it's gone. I've got 512. Two 256s and 128. That'll be enough just to test those cameras out, but I was hoping to put something a bit bigger. It didn't like the 8GB card. It just said check card. I'm a bit annoyed that I can't find my 1GB one. That one's got the 8GB card in it that the other camera's rejected. I've got a 4GB one in here. I could try that one, because if I'm only using this for taking stills, I don't need a 4GB card in it, so I could do with some fresh batteries in there as well. So I may actually get some double A's put on charge and charge them up. Anyway, I don't think my brain is quite functioning yet. Got a package in the post. I know what this one is. I think you guys will know that watch my videos as well. It's a Mega Drive game. I know it's not the Master System game I ordered, because the Master System game's got a case, and this one there does not. So I know it's the Mega Drive game I ordered, the Disney Tailspin one. I used to love that show when I was younger. Yep. Another game for my collection. Upside down, there we go. Yeah, it looks in good condition. Even the sticker isn't in too bad condition. Or the label, I should say, considering its age. Patents US. Caution, avoid exposing cartridge to extreme temperature. Be careful not to immerse cartridge in water. For protection, place cartridge inside protective plastic case when not in use, or just keep it out of direct sunlight. Right, I think that was it. I've just been sort of sitting here for the past 40 minutes just waking myself up before I decide to go get something to munch on. I've got the old pocket PC charged. I was using something as a stylus, but I can't remember what I got to work. I know that's got another SD card in, but that's a 256MB one, I think. I've got another one of those. I'm a bit miffed that I've lost that 1GB, because I think that would have been perfect to put in one of these. Oh, I'll stretch my legs. I'm sitting down too long. Let's put that back. Oops, I'm not. There's a point I haven't heard from Mum. She was going to put some money across into my bank so I could get her a few bits. I can't remember what those bits were. Actually, I can remember two. So I'm just going to log into my bank. So I'm going to turn you away from the screen because of that reason. Got to stop and think for a second there. Okay, now we can continue. Oh, she didn't put nothing in, so she's either forgotten or she hasn't been paid. One or the other. Or she's just gonna do it after work. So I may get a phone call after 1:30. Another lovely day outside. There's about three, four days. Three or four days straight. Oh, bloody hell. And ever since we've had the sun, look how well the tree has bloomed out with its leaves. It weren't like that a couple of days ago. Oh yeah, one more at the window. Look! My trailer is empty, near enough. There's a few tyres and a wheel laying in it. One of those bike frames. That one there, the blue one, that's got to be stripped out of the parts I want. And that can go back down where it came from. Might pull out that X-rated bike and see if I can revive that. I may actually dig it out and bring it upstairs later if I'm feeling up to it. Right, anyway, I'm going to turn the camera off. I'm going to go find something to eat. Well, I'm back for a few minutes. Fired this camera up. The battery, literally about a minute after turning it on, went straight down to indicating it was half full. But that's where it sat, so maybe it's just my charger. I'm not using, you know, I'm using a incorrect charger to charge it, so it's probably not charging it to its full capacity. But never mind. But I have got some test footage on there. I'm going to drop, hopefully, when I figure out how to the PC in the bedroom. I actually forgot to say earlier, I was fiddling around with these last night and took the memory cards out, as both cameras said they were full, and yeah, they were full of photos, and on at least one of them there was some video clips. So I know they can record to memory card, but I don't know if this has got a limit to what size memory card you can put in here. I know it didn't like the 8GB one, but that was also a brand new one, a lot newer than the camera. I've got a 1GB hanging around somewhere, unless I've lost it. You know, something that big is easily lost. I don't think it's in anything. The one I'm using has got my 16 gigabyte in. That's got the 8 gigabyte in. And this thing I use to take photos with, I'm actually going to downgrade the memory card of that and probably put a 512 megabyte one in it. Or something similar. Because that's got my 4 gigabyte card in it. Which I can't actually remember where I got it from. I can't remember if I bought the 4 gigabyte or the 8 gigabyte brand new from Sainsbury's when they were on offer. Oh well. Right. I'm going to put that in the bedroom. I'm just waiting to see if Mum will turn up. She yesterday she was saying she wanted to drop some cash into my bank account. And just get me to pop across to QD's and the drugstore to get a few bits, but she never did, and I haven't heard anything from her. So I don't know if she decided she'd just pop in after work. So I might see her. Lazy ass is doing what he does best. When I was looking for adapters for those Panasonic cameras, I decided to sort the box out as well. Because all the cables had come, you know, become unravelled, and they were all getting tangled up, and it was just a mess. I've just got that bundle to do there. Well, I've got that in my undies drawer. It doesn't belong in my undies drawer. Right. Yeah, once I've got these adapters sorted and back under the bed, I can shift this bike and see what Scalextric set I kept under there. I'm pretty certain it was the Hornby. I'll be glad if it is, because then you can put two Scalextrics together, because they'll be the same type of connections on the track. Right. I need to test this one. I know it turns on, but I don't know if it records. basically the same with that one and that Panasonic. That one I know worked because I've just tested it all. the Samson, I know that Samson works because that was tested at Mum's. Because I know Biggles had that sitting around for weeks in his caravan. He got that from the tip months ago actually. And I know that was in Mum's and they were playing around with it and recording with it, so I know that actually works. My JVC over here, that's why I came in here actually. Batteries don't hold charge, but I know it turns on. So I've just got to do a test to see if it records. Or will it just be in, you know, a non-working museum piece? I'm running out of space on my museum over here, aren't I? I'm going to have to make some more space, I suppose. I could put some of the smaller devices along the front there. Yay! I want to do some car boots this year, but Mum's not been in the mood. Because I don't drive, I can't get to the bloody things. Because they're all out of town. Oh well. I'll disappear for a little while, because if Mum's going to turn up, it'll be roughly round about now, so talk to you later. I am just ahead. Right. Well, it's now 2:30. So I should go and see a dentist, I suppose. Bad joke, I know. Really bad joke. What I've been doing is just sitting here watching YouTube videos and browsing Facebook, and I've been playing with these two cars, and what I've basically done, well, as you can see, they now roll. The front wheels are not up in the air because I've taken everything off. There's no brushes, no magnet. There's actually magnets. Here they are, look. They were stuck underneath each car. I don't know what they were there for, if they were there to sort of help keep it on the track. I kept the motors as well. There's the two little motors. And so, you know, they're not full-size cars, and I don't have the track, and these are just a novelty thing, really, aren't they, you know? Probably from a cheap Chinese knockoff set, anyway. Because otherwise they'd probably have something like Hornby written on them. Just one of them sort of mini Scalextric toys that get played with once and then put in a cupboard. Probably cost about £20 brand new or something daft. So I just converted the cars into just normal toy cars a kid could play with. If I ever get to do a car boot, I might put them on there. Although, I have to admit, I do like the blue one. I don't know why, but I like the blue one. That was a stupid friggin' thing to do, and I went to take a drink out of there and cracked the glass straight on my teeth. Right, yeah, I just got a bit bored, so I decided to put the camera on and just show you what I've been doing. Not what I intended to do, because I still haven't got to the power adapters, but I thought, main reason, because I was actually waiting to see if I would hear from Mum, but still nothing, so she finishes, she finishes work at 1:30, so I definitely would have heard something by now. So I'm going to go into the bedroom and get those last handful of adapters sorted, the box back under the bed, the box full of electrical bits and pieces back under the bed, and I can just move the electric bike just to slide that Scalextric out there and see if I did keep the Hornby one. I'm going to be pissed if I didn't. Anyway, talk to you all, I don't know, half an hour or so, something like that. Okay, well, I've had a look at the Scalextric under the cabinet, and I did keep the Scalextric set. I ditched the Tomy one, except the cars. And they all fit on the same track, and it comes out of that. I've actually only just realised that this and this that came with the other Scalextric set is a Transformers set, and the track matches as well, which I thought it would be, because it's, you know, excuse me, from the same manufacturer. There's a magnet in there holding that to the track. So, yeah, I've got a selection of cars. Maybe in a little while I'll get this whole area cleared and I'll set up some sort of track and we'll see what cars work. That'll be interesting, wouldn't it? Now that one's just hasn't got brushes, it's got metal springy contacts. A little Volkswagen Golf, a little Peugeot 205. They're actually smaller in size than the Scalextric ones, but I think those Transformer ones are rather large anyway. Oh, we've got an important sticker on that side. I'll have to read that as it's important. Yeah, look at this. That's more the scale. They are slightly larger. Okay, well, that's going to be fun later, isn't it? I'm glad that was the one I kept. So glad. Right. You get the one straight with this set. That's what this is missing. It's missing the power supply. 16 volt in. Well, I'm actually guessing that Transformer with the other set is probably the same one. Close enough. to vault out, it's not going to make a lot of difference. It means they might run a little smidge slower, but probably nothing noticeable. But does that connector fit in this one? It does. Oh well. That actually looks absolutely identical to the one in the other Scalextric set, just without the transformer stickers. It's got it's got micro sticker on it, but it's got the red LED as well. So yeah, all I've done is changed the decals on it. Cheats. With this one as well, I've gone for the sort of a traditional style controller as well. That's the sort of style I remember them as. You didn't have these, you clipped them to the bottom of the track on the full size ones. I don't know if it's still like that. I don't even know if Scalextric is still produced. I'd love to know what happened to our old sets. I think they may have got sold years ago. Oh well. I'm going to have a tidy up in here and I'm going to set something up then. Like I've already said in yesterday's video, I know that red one isn't going to work because it's got no contacts. Because this one has, you see, it's got these two little metal tabs there. But apart from that, all the track is identical, so those will work on that. I've just used a different contact method. Right, I'll talk to you all later. So, stay tuned! Still not got anything set up yet, but in my defence, I did get distracted. A friend of mine popped up. He's only got one bike to use out of the two at the moment, and that developed a bit of an issue on his way back from a 9-mile ride. It's just the wheel bearings that had come loose and they're making a heck of a noise, but they did tighten, but at some point they probably will need replacing. Then I remembered my neighbour caught me yesterday and said he could hear creaking at night, late at night. And he said it actually sounded like a floorboard creaking, but there are no floorboards in here because there's a concrete floor. Now the only thing I can think of up here that would do it at night is the bed frame. Are you quite finished on my mattress? Because this has been creaking for quite a while. I've just put an extra bolt in there, now the bloody frame is twisted. I'm not sure how I'm going to fix that unless I just let my weight and the weight of the mattress and whatnot sort of hopefully straighten it out. Or I'll just take that bolt out that's causing it, because I think it's this rail that's twisted. See? See? So I've been round and I've tightened up all the bolts. They were a bit loose. Mind you, I haven't tightened them up in about 6 years since I've had the bed frame. And we lost the bolts, so I had to find my own bolts. So I have found a few bolts up that fit better, but the others are holding fine, so I'm not going to replace them. As I say, don't fix what ain't broke. I had to replace one up there because the thread went. Like I said, there was one missing under there, which I may actually take out. Just so the frame sits square again, because I've got a funny feeling it ain't going to straighten out, and as soon as I get on the bed it's just going to go lump straight on the floor. So I'd go from one problem to another. But here's a bit of advice, you know, if you do have a minor problem, you know, with whatever someone's doing, you know, some noise coming from their apartment or something, sometimes all you got to do is be polite when you bring it up. My neighbour does that all the time. And I do love it. I do love it when people are polite in how they, you know, bring up the problem. Because obviously I can't imagine, as his bedroom's directly below mine, that it would be nice listening to that when you're trying to sleep, you know. As I said earlier, that tightrope walking or something. As I said earlier, I have that car, or that car on the car park early in the mornings annoys me. So, I'm doing what I can to rectify the issue, you know. I don't want to make enemies with my neighbours here. And I've gone almost 7 years without making any enemies. I don't want to start making them now. So yeah, I've just been sorting the bed out. I'm just going to change my mind to just drop the bolt out of the bottom here so the frame sits square. And just crank that one down as hard as I can. Then put my slats back on and my mattress back on. Yeah. Oh, pardon me. Just thinking. What have I got to do next? I'm actually worked up quite a sweat, actually, while I'm standing up here. I'll open that one. Oh, I've got under here, I've got two of these crates of cars. I've got that. My adapters, bike lights, electrics, heat sinks. I don't even know what I'm keeping all those, to be honest. But I can guarantee as soon as I throw them all out, I'll end up wanting one. There's actually a fan in there that's not meant to be in there. Lots of random computer pieces in here as well. Mostly mice, I think. A few other random parts I've thrown in there. See, I don't even know why I keep these. I haven't found a disk drive that actually fits. Oh, pardon me. Not yet. We'll have another play. That's got external power supply as well. As well as the USB cable. I'll have a look at that later. So I'm just going to finish sorting the bed out. With my hexagon key from there. And I'm going to set up just a mini oval or something that I can do just to test run the cars, see what ones do work and what ones don't. I don't know, I could eBay it, I could car boot it, I could, I don't know, do something with it. You know, Biggles give it to me for free, so I don't know what the hell I'm going to do with it, to be honest. I've got no. I would keep it if I had the room to set it up, but I haven't really got the room. Anyway, I'll talk to you all later. I'm starting to get a bit peckish as well. Oh, it's nearly 6 o'clock, that's why. Alright then. Pour myself a cold drink. Wipe the sweat out of my eyeballs. Ooh. There's been a lovely breeze today, which has helped. Anyway, I'll talk to you later. It's nearly 9 o'clock, literally. I didn't actually realise it was getting that late. Jeez. I went and got a portion of chips for tea because that's all I fancied. Done a couple of slices of bread and butter and had chip butties. I've got the bed to stop creaking and squeaking as much as I can, but I think it's time for a new bed base. I think it is wearing out slowly. Well, I've had it. Got to be getting close to 7 years now. Was my sister's bed base, hence, if anyone's noticed, all the lovely little sort of flowers and hearts and things at the ends. Don't fucking bother me, it's a bed base, I sleep on it, that's it, that's all I use it for. But I think, I can't remember how long my sister had it before that. It's got to be at least 10 years old, that bed base. Maybe even older. So yeah, probably time to replace it. It's better, it's not creaking nowhere near as much or as loudly as it was, so yeah, that should do as a temporary fix. But it's just clicked 9 o'clock. But I put a status up about it on Facebook and someone said I must have really nice neighbours. Yeah, I don't think any of us, you know, want to get on each other's bad sides, you know. I don't want to get on the bad side of my neighbours, so for the sake of tightening up a few friggin' bolts, you know, I might as well just tighten up a few friggin' bolts instead of, you know, become their worst enemies. You know, for the sake of a couple of fucking bolts. Busy night out there. I've made a little loop track with this, but I seem to be having a contact problem. I can't get those two to work at all. But the copper contacts do look a bit dirty, so those ones are actually squished. It's the same with this. I don't. For Nemo, your cat food stink. See if I do that. It's plugged in. The LED is on. No. No, the trigger works. If I can just park you somewhere where you can see the car badly. So I'm just trying to position my screen so I can see as well. If I do where the drive wheels are at the front, aren't they? If I do this, can I do it? Can't get it to do it on that one. Let's try this one. But if I leave it like that, nothing, see? So I've got a connection problem here somewhere. Not on the track itself, but the cars. That's a feature I don't remember on the original Scalextric controllers. You pull this right back and it actually does nothing. And I remember I used to, on the older ones, they didn't have that feature. You used to be able to pull it back like that and the cars would go flying around the track and, well, fly off the corners and you'll end up breaking your cars. But just going to make sure the blue one's working. Oh. Blue track doesn't appear to be working at all. Ah, I wonder if there's a... See, these have got those little magnets underneath as well, and they really do cling to these metal tracks, so I don't know if they're actually acting as a hindrance. Now it's working. It's really weird. Oh, I did find out something interesting with these. As it's a transformer, or from the transformer Scalextric, I might actually get that track out tomorrow and try the transformer cars on the actual other track. Look at that. They actually transform. I've got to have it like that, have I? No. See. Ooh. It moved. I can feel it hum. It's trying to move. Oh well. I might actually pack this one up and just leave that power supply out, as in that bit, and probably try everything else. be a shame. I was actually going to put them up on, both up on Facebook and sell them together, because the track matches and whatnot, so I can't see the track being an issue, to be honest. I really can't. Where'd the I know where they came from.
Duh.
Oh. Right, I don't want to put the cars away yet. These go together really easy. They slot together really, really easy. I was pretty impressed with that. I know the view is crap at the moment, but I'm only doing a boring task of packing this away. It's got to go in that pile. Yeah. I was then about to say, if you get knocked, it's because I'm moving the track. And you got knocked just as I said it. Well, it's the same rating as the other track. Like, all the cars are rated 12 volt. So, I can't see that being the issue. Well, you can tell when I lift the car up that it's not the issue. It still works perfectly. So, I'm not really sure what's going on, to be honest. Like I said, I'll try the other track. I'll just make another simple track or something up with it, I don't know. There's a lot of track with this kit. Oh yeah. I'll use the controllers that came with the other set as well. Got a warning on these controllers that just warn you that they just a little label on the back of these. I'll read the other one out actually. I can't read that one out because I've just covered it all up with a bloody cable. What we've got is just an important information label. Hand controllers get warm in use and give off a slight smell when new. This should clear after approximately 5 minutes. While the hand controller is in operation, do not hold the cars in fixed position, preventing the rear driving wheels from rotating. This will permanently damage the motor. Here we go. So we mustn't do that. It does help if they bloody go in the first place. Put Ella one away. I wonder why the controllers don't actually match the colour of the cars. Wouldn't that have made a bit more sense, you know? Green one for the Jag and a red one for the F40. Oh no. Just my thought on that. I'd have thought that would have made a bit more sense. And a bit more appealing to play with, possibly, you know. Just for the sake of changing the colour of the plastic. Oh, shit. Right. Cover that up. What I'm going to do, I'm going to stick that back up there out of the way. I'm going to go and grab the other one, set something up, and we'll see if we have any luck with the other one. I give up. It's meant to be a crossroads section in here, but that seems to be missing from this set. I actually thought it was there unless I accidentally threw that out. Like a pillock, I might have accidentally thrown that out. Oops. And it looks like I may not have pushed some of the track together properly. Oh well. might actually explain the intermittent problems, why it works on some parts and not others. But you know, I think it's likely an issue with those the braid pickups, as they call them in the instructions. I always used to call them brushes. But the braided pickups underneath don't look too badly worn, so I can't imagine that being the issue. Oh well. I can go back in the box. I don't know what I'll do with it. Pardon me. Someone post up on the Regenerate North Horsham group earlier. I think it was this morning. Apparently they'd been for a walk on the Memorial Park, and it's full of litter from people that were there the evening before, because they always used to lock the Memorial Park at dusk, you know, and open it up at dawn. The only problem is with that, people used to jump the fence. Not that I ever did when I was a kid. Anyway, someone else has just said, and even I said, you know, there's litter everywhere. Litter gets dropped everywhere. The wind also adds to it, because if a bin is overflowing, you know, a public bin is overflowing, the wind is just going to blow it and it'll end up everywhere. So it's probably a mix on big areas like that. I mean, even on my little car park over there, if I see any litter out there while I'm out there, then I'll go and get my little picker and pick it up. It don't take 2 seconds. Even though there's a friggin' bin right across the road, it's a stone's throw away, people still leave litter on our car park. Don't even think about it. I'm watching you. Don't.
Flame hell.
And there's an interesting thing being shared around at the moment and in the media of a maths question that apparently adults can't answer. And it's a maths question for 7-year-olds. So I'm just going to scroll down. And I'm just going to... Stupid cat. Right. The question reads, there are some people on a train. 19 people get off the train at the first stop. 17 people get on the train. Now there are 63 people on the train. How many people were on the train to begin with? And of course, there's a long way to work this out, which I did. Stupidly, but there's also a very quick way. You just add 2 to 63. Because there's 2 is the difference between the number of people that got off and the number of people that got on. So if 17 got on, then there would be 2 less than before. Meaning 63. But the way, you know, the other way you could do it, which is the way I did it, I'd subtracted 17 from 63 and then added 19 to the answer of that sum, and got the same answer, 65. So I don't see how adults can actually get that wrong. I failed maths in school. I got an F in my GCSEs. I don't even know I could work that out. I actually worked it out doing it the long way, but I still worked it out. for some reason I just saw the long way to do it and not the quick and easy way, you know, just add two to that.
Duh.
Never mind. I don't believe that adults are getting that wrong, or as many adults they are claiming are getting that wrong. I don't know why. This is weird. When I was in school, I couldn't get maths, didn't understand math, hated math, failed math. Nowadays, I'm actually finding myself understanding math a lot more, and a lot more easier. I know they say people with autism are a bit slow at learning certain things. I've got this. Can be a bit slow at learning certain subjects, but that takes the mickey. I'm 32 and I'm only just now getting it. I bet if I could go back and retake, you know, maths, I could probably get my grades up. Now that I do actually understand it a bit more. I still can't do my multiplication tables, though. I actually don't know them all. I know the easy ones, you know, like the 2 times table, the 5 times and the 10 times tables. I can use my fingers. I'm good at using my fingers and my toes. What the hell? Oh, I know what that is. It's a Mark II Ford Escort. You might think it was a van, but it isn't. It's based on the van, though, but it's like a camper thing. I prefer the actual Ford Escort car, but if I had the cash, I would consider 4995. It looks like he's got in the for sale. In the for sale thing in the window. I would have to have a good look around. If you actually look at the top here, you can see a little catch, because that roof does open. If I remember correctly, yeah, it's like a camper thing. It's in Chroma, but I don't know what road that is on looking down. That barge is bloody close. Jesus. I used to see him get close when I was in Chroma, but not that bloody close. Pardon me. Oh, bollocks to it. I'm just scrolling through right. Hoodie, hoodie, ha, hoodie, hoodie, ha. How the hell did that tire get like that? Apparently, this British Airways A380 lands with a square tire. How the fuck did a wheel turn like that? I keep telling myself I need to stop talking to weirdos, but if I did that, I wouldn't have any friends left. I don't have many friends anyway. No one loves me. Nobody bloody loves me enough. Am I bothered? Nah. Ow! Nada. Yeah. Oh, I'm gonna leave it at that. Sure there's something else I want to do. Can't imagine track size would make any difference, you know. It's all going to be the same friggin' voltage going around the track, isn't it? Ugh, fucking all right. Ugh. Oh well. I'm just going to pop you down there for a moment while I dismantle the track. Okay, that one hard. According to the instructions, you are meant to pull it straight apart like that in a straight line. If it doesn't fall to pieces first. This is a bit interesting. I've dismantled it. Definitely not a track issue. Oh, never mind. Never mind. They're all free anyway, so who cares? Get off the track, you. I bet there's absolutely nothing in this aside from a resistor for the LED. And just because I can, I'm going to open it up and have a look. And we'll do that at the desk now, because my screwdrivers are up there. Where is there? Only four screws? Yep. Four Phillips screws. There we go, we'll sit you on there. And actually, just to make things a bit more interesting, get the one out of here and we'll compare it. And we'll see if they really did just rebadge the top. Because I'm pretty certain that's all they've done. Right. Need some light. I can't see without any light. Where's my switch? There it is. There's my salt. Cola. Vinegar. What did I do with them? I had a bunch of tools on the table here earlier. I'm just going to turn the fan off so there's no wind noise. Ooh, right under my bloody nose, I hear. Twat. Which was Transformers, here we go. Bet you there is next to nothing in this. Like I said, there's probably a resistor going to the LED just to reduce the current so it doesn't blow. There's some really short, stubby screws. A circuit board, and there is four wires. And the circuit board just pops out. It's not even screwed in, it's just sat in there. So what you have on this, we've got the two controller sockets, power socket, we have, they're labelled T's. They're probably thermistors then, I guess. T1A and T2A. T2B as well. Okay. LED1, then we've got all those ceramic caps. Four ceramic caps. A diode, four diodes. A ceramic cap there. Where's the LED then? LED's at the top there. Yeah. I can see a that resistor is in line with that LED. Micro power something or other. So, stick that to one side. I'll put that together again later. Might actually help if I put it together with everything lined up like that. Okay. I'm not expecting this one to be any different, to be honest. I was having a bit of a bored evening at the moment, so why not? The screws are exactly the same, board is exactly the same. I'm expecting there to be the exact same circuit board with the exact same four wires coming off of it. Because you're going to have a controller to each track, aren't you? Okay. Well, different colour wires. We have two blue, one grey, one black for some reason. And this one's actually different. This one looks like it's got a chip, controller chip on it instead. No, it's just done with four diodes, this one. And it's got the thermistors missing as well. Well, apparently they were capacitors, according to that. But the LED is still there, the resistor is closer. And all I've got there are four diodes in a bridge rectifier format. So I wonder why I've decided to do t'other one differently. Do you know? Yeah, they're in a bridge rectifier format as well. You can see it's got these little thermistors there. I presume that's what the T stand for. I can't think of anything like that. Anything else like that begin with a T anyway, not off the top of my head. Simple as that, now I just put the covers back on and screw it together. Yeah, that one's got 16 volt. Oh, that one doesn't have a label on it. How do they get the 0 to 12 volt? Just, I don't know, magic, the magic pixies, they do it. Right, together in a minute. Ho-hum, right, call it quits for this video and get this all up and edited and blah, blah, blah. So, oops. I'm gonna figure out what I'm doing with my screen there. Thanks for watching. I've got no idea what I'm gonna be doing tomorrow. I don't think I'm putting the right cover on this because it's not clipping on properly. That one is though. Oh, sorry about that. We'll sort that in a minute. Right. I've got no idea what I'm doing tomorrow. Sugar, not at all. Got that kid's bike I want to do just to get the fucking thing out of my way. The red Apollo. I don't think I've actually shown that one on camera. I'll drag that up here tomorrow. I did have a look at the X-rated frame when I was down there, and forks were completely seized on it, so I just took it apart for parts and put the frame on the trailer ready to go down the dump. Might whip the crank off it tomorrow. I don't think I need a crank, but I suppose a spare one wouldn't hurt. But I got everything else that was usable off of it. It's just the frame was in shit condition and the forks are seized, so I did try to get the forks off in the vain hope they'd fit this Peugeot frame up here, but I can actually see looking at the frame now they wouldn't have fit. Steer tube was too short. Oh well. Hopefully if I can get down the recycle centre either Thursday or at the weekend, I can perhaps grab something, if there's something there, of course, that I can do this Peugeot with, because my cousin's after a bike, so I've got to build him one up. He's not very tall, he's like me, so I'm thinking possibly the silver one I've got out front would be better for him. Or I may find one down the dump in the meantime. Who knows? He said it'll be sort of like 2 or 3 weeks before he'd be able to pick it up anyway, so who knows what I'm going to come across in that time. Anyway, thanks for watching. I'm going to get this video edited. All that effort for that. Oh well. I'm just going to chill out for the rest of the evening. So I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. Bye.